Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Darshan Talks. We have Deborah Collier with us, and Deborah is a patient advocate, a patient expert, and she's told us a lot of interesting things about her experiences as a patient, some of which have included some of her experiences having multiple cancers. She has, over time, been referred to, in her own words, in many, many different ways. And one of the more interesting things I thought was being referred to as the mother of research advocacy.
This is the Darshan Talks podcast, regulatory guy, irregular podcast with host Darshan Kulkarni. You can find the show on Twitter at Darshan Talks or the show's website at darshantalks.com.
We're going to be exploring research advocacy with her, but before we get into something like that, I want to talk about a comment she just made to me, where she talked about this idea that that people treat patients in the healthcare system as patients, almost as a number. And she re-emphasized patients are people. And I wanted to let her sort of expound on that thought. So Deborah, over to you.
Okay. Well, I think the important thing to remember is that patient, that is a label. And it's not something that a person who's being diagnosed with an illness is used to or thinks about as themselves. They are still the same person they were just before their diagnosis. But the system now treats you totally differently. And sometimes, like, you've had a lobotomy, but you're still the same person. You have skills, you have life experiences, all of things that enter into your experience. I think the other thing that's really important to remember is that the medical part of that person, them being a patient, quote unquote, is only one part of their life. They're the only one in that situation who does not want to be there. And so it's important to remember because,
absolutely,
you know, people are basically always blaming patients, not only for their own illness, but because they don't adhere quite right, quote
right.
unquote, or comply, quote unquote, or this or that. Well, you know, when you're a patient, it's an endurance test.
Yep.
And it's not something you know about, A, B, want to know about, C, understand very well because of all of the lingo and jargon that's used in medicine. Mm-hmm. You feel like you've just been catapulted onto a new planet without a roadmap, a dictionary, or any type of survival training. And unfortunately, especially in the US, the healthcare system doesn't give you the tools that you need to quickly come up to speed. So you're in a foreign land. You are having to make some of the most important decisions in your life in a very short period of time in a different language than what you're used to. So you need advice. You need people helping you. That includes not only the doctor, but the entire healthcare professionals, team, providers. And there aren't always good answers. You know, the thing about the words that are used in medicine, like uncertainty and risk, are mm-hmm. things that patients have to deal with from the very beginning, because
right.
we have very few actual solutions for people who get sick or injured or get a disease. That's when you find out how much of an art medicine really is instead of a science.
So you made this reference about having the entire healthcare team involved. Have you ever actually had pharmacists be involved in your care outside maybe just dispensing a medication? And has that played an important role in any way?
Actually, I have not. I have met pharmacists through the research side of things that I work on. But as far as care, both my own personal care and really in helping, you know, hundreds, maybe even thousands of people through the years, I have not had much interaction with pharmacists.
So one of the things they teach us in pharmacy school, and as we talked about before, I'm a pharmacist by training as well, worked over 20 years in various settings, including hospitals and in retail pharmacy. And the part that really throws me off is in hospitals and retail pharmacy, in pharmacy school, they actually just tell us, you are a very, very important part of the research process, which you really have to do, and an important part of healthcare. You have to engage with patients. You have to talk to patients. You are often the person who's most available to patients. And here we have a patient going, I need help. And it's surprising to me that in all this time, that's not something that's happened. Have you found pharmacists to generally be unavailable, or have they been available, but you've thought they may not be the right person? What is your take on that?
Well, I'm sorry to say this. I don't mean this badly at all, but they have been invisible in the process. I did not, first of all, think about a pharmacist to talk to. That would have been interesting. It was not something that was brought up to me in my many, many healthcare experiences. And not just for me personally, but with the people that I have helped through the years. It's not on my checklist. It's not in my thought process. And no one has brought that up to me.
Again, you're an expert in this area. I recognize I'm sort of putting you a little bit on the spot. So your answer, maybe I need to give it some more thought. But if you were thinking about it, do you see a role they can play? Or do you think that they do fit better in the background, sort of helping make sure that things work out the way they are? Like, what do you see the roles of the pharmacist as a patient?
Well, I think the answer to that is it depends. I think it depends.
Sound like a lawyer. Yes,
I learned from you. I think it depends on the illness or medical condition or disease, number one. I think in some places, like for instance, in cancers, and I do call it cancers instead of oncology, I do know the word, they would play more of a supportive role. However, one of the things that is rarely explained, especially in standard care, well, you know, in research, you have an informed consent, and which is done poorly, but at least there is information there. In standard treatment, a lot of people aren't necessarily given good information about what these drugs are, what they do in your body, what you may feel as far as side effects. And that could be useful. So I think there is information, whether or not it's an actual person delivering that or not, who is a pharmacist, or there is better information that we can give to people. So they have, one of the things that's always missing for patients is context. Mm-hmm. And that is the most important word to remember out of anything that I say. Context means also setting good expectations, realistic expectations, so that the person who has now become a patient has an idea of what's going to happen to them, why, and what they can do about it if they need to. So those would be the things I would think would be important from a pharmacist standpoint.
But you said it depends, and you said maybe in research, sorry, in cancer and oncology, it may not be as important as in some other disease states. How did you draw that distinction?
Well, it's interesting because, you know, for decades now, cancer has kind of become an institution in certain fields. So the oncologist is the one that you go to. The thing I remind oncologists about is that's the last place you end up, not the first. And so there are many other types of paths that you go through and different parts of the medical system and special subspecialties that you go to for that. And I say that because even primary care physicians have trouble getting information about their cancer patients.
Right.
Because oncology has kind of become a closed system. Now, many of us, including those of us who are patient advocates, have tried to push that door open more and make it more collaborative, make it more open so that there is more communication between the different pieces of the medical system that need information and, of course, that patients need.
This is a perfect way to segue. So we're gonna end very quickly, but I wanted to put out a note to the other pharmacists out there, which is you just heard this from a extremely well-informed patient advocate about how she is looking for context. She is looking for patients to be treated as more than as less than a person almost. They've been treated as less than a person, and we want to remember that these are people. And pharmacists, we went to school to do exactly that. And I want to challenge pharmacists, especially oncology pharmacists, who are often in the background talking to nurses, making sure the drug-drug interactions and the drug-disease interactions are being minimized. How about getting outside that IV hood and talking to patients? There's obviously a need, and you may have a lot of the skill sets that patients are looking for. But stay tuned.
This is the Darshan Talks podcast, regulatory guy, irregular podcast with host Darshan Kulkarni. You can find the show on Twitter at Darshan Talks or the show's website at darshantalks.com.